in between, I didn't realize this. I was like, huh, CM Punk's not on Raw today. I'm like, that's kind of strange. He's like the number, maybe number three, number two face in the company. Even if Daniel Bryan's number one or Cena's one, Daniel Bryan's two, CM Punk is third, and he was champion for 400 days. Yeah. You know, over last year when he lost to The Rock, CM Punk wasn't on Raw. I'm like, that's kind of weird. I didn't realize it. I went online to look at some of the results. CM Punk quit the company.
Yeah, that I know. That
CM Punk quit the company a week ago, a week and a half ago.
Yeah, yeah.
Not storyline.
No, he quit. Real.
He quit. He had enough. He had enough because he was tired of the direction of the company. He was burnt out. Yeah, he quit because of Daniel Bryan being...
It was solidarity for a buddy. It was. Here's the thing. Daniel Bryan and him came up in the same circles. I've seen CM Punk wrestle in the same ROH rings that I saw Daniel Bryan wrestling. Like, they know each other. And I hate to say it because, like, a lot of times I don't like the atmosphere of stuff like ROH, but...
Ring of Honor?
Yeah, but those guys... They do come up together, and they do have respect for each other, and they do have each other's backs, which is something I like that you don't see in WWE or WWF. So even though, there's good matches in ROH, there definitely is. I don't know, nothing about it's ever hooked me. I do appreciate the fact that they all, heel or face in the storyline, they all are like with each other as a unit.
That's cool. So this is the problem now. You can't have one of your most popular wrestlers, CM Punk, arguably, he's in the top three.
Well, I heard Vince wants him back, but Triple H doesn't.
Well, I'll get to that. I don't want to get too behind the scenes with that stuff. I guess I'll have to. So he walked out also because Triple H wanted to face, or he was set to face Triple H at WrestleMania.
Yeah.
And CM Punk said that's bullshit. He said, yeah. I've been screwed out of the main event the past 3 years. Rock main evented two in a row, walked back 2 years in a row. Main evented 2 years back against John Cena as just a regular match. And then last year for the championship, when he was champion, when Rocky won the championship, main evented again. And last year, CM Punk faced Undertaker, which is an honor to face Undertaker, and lost him in supposedly a really good match, which I didn't see. But he did get screwed. Yeah. He wasn't in the main event. He lost the title for last year, and then the main event before that, he wasn't in the main event as a champion. At that point, he'd been champion for like 5-6 months and still wasn't in the main event of WrestleMania. It was The Rock and Cena, and it was bullshit. That all these part-timers, and The Rock's a big movie star, but it's still bullshit that you have these part-timers coming back, and then all of a sudden they're in the main event, and they're not even no longer the best workers, and all the guys who've been on the road for 300 days a year, they're out of their spot, and it is bullshit.
It is, and the thing is, I like The Rock. I thought he was
The Rock at least can wrestle. Batista can't wrestle. Right,
The Rock can wrestle, and The Rock had charisma, so I like The Rock, but it's still bullshit to give someone who has minimal interaction with the company the big spot. Like, the people who have been working for it all year should take it.
Yeah, and Batista couldn't came and wrestle. And he was boring 5 years ago. He wasn't interesting. And so who? I don't care he's in a Marvel movie. That has nothing to do with the wrestling, your business. People aren't going to know about that he's going to be in the movie for like 6 months anyway.
People are assuming there's going to be some sort of crossover appeal there that isn't there. He's going to get booed as being an asshole who took a spot that someone else should have had, regardless, because the people who are watching wrestling aren't thinking about the fact that he's in this new movie that they want to go see.
Batista also tweeted when he came back, because in storyline wise, Del Rio is pissed. Alberto Del Rio, who's been champion a couple times, he comes back and he's pissed that Batista's stealing quote unquote a spotlight. Batista actually tweeted out, I think he had it deleted or tweeted out, hey, I'm returning at a time where it's a C-list stars in a B-list time period for WWE. He actually tweeted that, insulting the entire roster. Then he still gets a spot. He still comes back to the Rumble, gets booed. He's going to be main eventing WrestleMania. It should have been Daniel Bryan winning the Rumble, Daniel Bryan winning WrestleMania. If WrestleMania, it's already the whole storybook ending. If they had Chris Benoit win the Rumble and then WrestleMania.
Chris Benoit?
Yeah, if they had him do that, and Benoit at the time in 2000... Chris
Benoit
won the Rumble 2004 in WrestleMania. Yes. What I'm saying is, if they gave him the chance to do that, and he was semi-popular, they built him up well in between the Rumble and that as the underdog, but the point is, Daniel Bryan is hugely popular, and they're not giving him that shot, that even chance to shine as the face of the company, after Cena's been the face of the company for like 9 years. What the fuck are they doing? Just what are they doing? They always say, well, our wrestlers have to build themselves up, and they gotta grab that brass ring and do all that.
Well,
these are our wrestlers. CM Punk built himself up in WWE after getting buried. Daniel Bryan built himself up. And now they don't get the shot. So now even if they... I think what they're going to do is this. I think what they're going to do is they have the Elimination Chamber match coming up. I think what they're going to have is Orton or Batista win it there. Or do some... Or no, they're going to have someone else win the title or Orton's going to keep it. So Batista will still be in the main event. They'll somehow add Daniel Bryan as a triple threat, which is going to still tarnish it though, because he should have won the Rumble. He should have been in at number one or number two or number 10 and beat up won the Rumble.
If he gets the shot, I don't care. What I need to see is a one-on-one. I don't need to see a triple threat.
Triple threats are cheap. Triple threats are cheap unless you beat the champion. And fortunately, 10 years ago, which I saw in person, Benoit did beat Triple H and not Shawn Michaels and got the championship.
Yeah.
But Benoit won the Rumble at number two. Bryan was never given that, and the fans wanted to see Bryan, little 5'6" Daniel Bryan, tear through everyone else like a buzzsaw and come out the champion, and they totally screwed it. And what makes it worse is that they're launching the WWE Network in like 3 weeks. So they pissed off a good chunk of their fan base before the launch of the network.
Well, it'll be interesting to see if they find a way to fix it between then and now, but they won't.
Who knows? I mean, they've totally shot themselves in the foot before. So CM Punk leaves.
I just hope they feel like they're up against the wall.
CM Punk leaves because of Daniel Bryan getting screwed over, and he feels he's gotten screwed over himself. And he's like, he even said, "I like Dave Bautista." He actually said it at, he actually ruined, 2 days before, he was in like Wizard World or whatever, at some sort of comic convention, I think in Portland.
I heard about that.
It's online. He ruined the ending of the Royal Rumble. I'd never seen it before. Yep. But he looked depressed, and he was just like, yeah, Batista, he's going to get a shot, you know, but I don't think, you know, he comes back. And he said, I like Dave Batista, but he's, you know, it's Daniel Bryan's year. And he's right, but now it's been ruined. Unless they can turn it around quickly. Bryan's got to, if WrestleMania doesn't end with Daniel Bryan holding the championship, that's it. Like, that's it. The whole year is going to be gone.
And I really do think it. Wrestling topic done for the night.
We're done with wrestling?
We're done with wrestling for the night. Got to rein it in.